Hi, everyone. Do you wish that there was a more simple way to find files and folders on your file server, especially when it comes to your multimedia or your digital assets folder? I'm going to give you a few suggestions in this video in hopes to give you a better process or way to organize your folder with the special focus on the multimedia folder. And as you all know, we are getting more and more video files that relate to specific cases on a day-to-day basis, and it's certainly not slowing up. What we have to do now is go ahead, get everything set up and structured in a way so that you're not confused about how old something is, whether you can delete it or not. A whole barrage of very specific details that are related to this, especially knowing that we need to keep the folder or the video for a certain amount of time. And because of the need to keep this for a certain amount of time, that's going to continue to build on your file server, therefore reducing the amount of storage that you have. So we're going to try to tackle this as much as possible, and we feel that this can be done most definitely with the organization of it. We're going to start off with the multimedia folder. And one suggestion, you may have a structure that works for you. That's great. Just want to give you a couple little insights in hopes that maybe you can design some of this with the current settings that we have applied to these folders. Number one, we are in the multimedia folder, so we know where we're at. And we want to have more of a general aspect in the beginning and then go down to a more focused naming resolution as we go. So in this case, the data that is stored in the multimedia folder, we are told right now in the year 2017 that they need to be held or stored for archival purposes for a minimum of 5 years. So these data files will be in this specific folder, and after that 5-year time limit is up, then they may be removed. So we'd like to suggest that you start off by creating a folder that has the year specifically pertaining to the year that the case was implemented, or the offense date, kind of when that can actually be removed from the server. So in this case, we're going to say we started off in 2014, we got 2015 folder, the 2016, and 2017. I'm going to show you here in the 2015 folder. The way that we feel it may be beneficial for you would be, especially if you have multiple counties in your district, is to go ahead and start off with that county name. Then you add a dash, and then you go into the last name, and then the first name, and then any court-related case or case ID assigned to that specific number. Going into the 2016 folder, I'll show you how that will look with just a few more folders added to it. And in here, instead of having county names and having to go into the county folder with multiple subfolders and more folders and more folders, I'm sure you may have run into this a few times, but where you have file names or strings that are so long because you've got one folder inside another folder inside of two other folders and on down the row, and there is a limitation with how long that can be. So in this case, we, number one, we know that we're in the multimedia folder, we're in the year 2016, so in 5 years from now we can actually just completely delete this folder when the time comes. We start off, we've got the county that this case is in, and then it follows up just by a dash, the last name, the first name, and then the case-related information or the case ID. Well, that wraps up this video. I hope that helps give you a better understanding of a potential way to restructure and reorganize your multimedia folder on your file server. Hope this adds to the improving efficiency. And the search feature, you can always use that to find the files. But within this organized structure with your folders here, we hope you can see that you can get a good grasp for what it is and exactly where it's at. And say if you happen to know the name of the person, all you would have to do right here is actually go in, type that information, and you would see that this one case would come up right there if you didn't actually know what year that may be bound. So I hope that gives you a little better demonstration. Then from there, you can simply just go into it, find out what's there. I hope that helps. Once again, please consider this as a reorganizing insight for your file server and the multimedia folder, and hope you can put it to good use. Thank you very much. Have a great day.